A good eye, a steady hand, and the ability to recognize the perfect shot. These are the practice skills of anyone involved in shooting sports. And no one knows shooting better than the folks here at USA Shooting. But their first and foremost concern is safety. Today we're at the Olympic Training Center in Colorado Springs to get some tips from our top shooters and safety experts. Whether you're an Olympian in training or you simply enjoy sports like target shooting and hunting, safety is always the first consideration. The bottom line is, accidents can be avoided if you know what you're doing. In this video, you'll hear from members of the U.S. shooting team and other experts on gun safety. But no matter how or where they use firearms, their message is always the same. Knowledge equals safety. Safety begins before you even pick up a firearm. First, familiarize yourself with its mechanical and handling characteristics. Doug Painter is president of the National Shooting Sports Foundation.
You know, for the new gun owner, the most important thing is to read the owner's manual. That will tell you what you need to know about how the action operates, how to safely load and unload the firearm, and about all of the safety features, especially how to work the safety switch.
There are many different safety mechanisms, although not all firearms have one. Here are four different firearms with four different safety releases. They each work differently, so make sure you read the instruction manual, especially the section on how to know whether the safety is in the on or off position. If you're uncertain, contact your local firearm dealer. So, what else should you know before you get started?
When you're reading that owner's manual, check for the type of ammunition that matches your firearm. Be certain that the ammunition you're using matches the specifications contained in the gun's instruction manual and the manufacturer's markings on the gun. And most importantly, always assume every firearm is loaded.
That last point is the golden rule of safe firearm handling. Always assume every firearm is loaded. And like Doug said, ammunition can be confusing. This pistol can be ordered in many different calibers. To the untrained eye, they all look identical, but they can only shoot the ammunition that they are designed for. This revolver can fire either .357 Magnum or .38 Special ammunition. This 12-gauge shotgun takes a 3-inch shell, while this 12-gauge only takes a 2¾. Look for a stamp on the firearm and read the instruction manual. Using the correct ammunition will protect both you and your firearm from potential injury and damage. Don't allow shortcuts or experiments to ruin your shooting experience. But there's still more to know before you pick up that firearm. Sean is a world champion shooter and Olympic team member. He knows a lot about firearm safety.
It doesn't seem like it was all that long ago that my mom and dad gave me that BB gun at the age of 4. It was at that time that my dad would take me to the field and instill in me the safety tips that I still use to this day. Three of the things that he taught me were to always wear great eye protection to protect my eyes, hearing protection to protect my hearing, and third, to always assume that every firearm is always loaded.
Good tips. Protecting your sight and hearing are essential. So, how do you choose the right protection? For hearing protection, look for the proper fit and the sound reduction rating. The measure for loudness is decibels, which is abbreviated dB. You should find a dB reduction rating on the package. The higher the number, the better, because it's quieter. You can also buy battery-powered muffs and custom-fitted plugs. These allow you to hear at normal or even amplified volume levels until you shoot. Then the electronics automatically cut the sound level. A muzzle blast can quickly and permanently damage your hearing. For eye protection, look for shatter-resistant lenses that wrap around for full coverage and comply with the American National Standards Institute guidelines for safety. Yellow lenses increase the contrast between light and dark. If you're shooting in bright sunlight, look for UV protection. Some frames come with several lenses so you can switch the lens to fit the conditions. you can avoid injury from things like branches to ejected shell casings with proper eye protection. Okay, so now you're ready to handle your firearm. Zach is a 4-H shooting sports ambassador, and Lindsay is a USA shooting team member. They're both experts in handling firearms.
When you're getting ready to shoot your firearm, always assume that every firearm is loaded.
Also, when firing your firearm, you should make sure you point in a safe direction or downrange.
Remember to keep your finger off the trigger until your target is within your sights.
You should never rely on the safety on your firearm because your firearm could always be loaded.
Remember the golden rule of safe firearm handling. If you always assume every firearm is loaded, you'll always make sure that it's pointed in a safe direction in case of unwanted discharge. Keep your finger away from the trigger until you're ready to shoot. Finally, use your safety, but never assume that it will absolutely prevent unintended firing. Did you know there are also rules for accepting a firearm? You should make sure the action is open. Check the chamber to ensure that it is empty. Use both hands when passing and accepting a firearm, and say thank you to the passer. And finally, confirm for yourself that the firearm is unloaded. Another important rule is to be sure the barrel is clear of obstructions before shooting and that the gun is safe to operate.
Safe firearm handling is all about being aware and being prepared. Competing with the USA shooting team can be lots of fun. The team members get to travel, meet new friends, and see new places. But when they step up to the line and get ready to shoot, their focus is on the target and the next shot.
That's so important. Always be sure of your target and what's beyond. Listen to USA shooting team member Haley.
I started shooting shotguns when I was 10 years old when my dad, Larry, opened up a shooting range in Iowa. The one thing I most enjoy about the Olympic shooting sports is the people that I get to meet and the journey that's very satisfying. And it's something that I can do for the rest of my life. Over the years, one thing I've learned is that every day when I pull my gun out of the case, I check the barrel to make sure it's clear.
That's right. Then, after you're finished shooting and cleaning your firearm, wash your hands and the area around your nose and mouth with cool water to remove any lead residue or cleaning solvents that might be left behind. So, now that you're finished using your firearm, what do you do with it? Officer Douglas has some important tips for firearm transportation and storage.
Firearms should never be kept where they are easily accessible to an unauthorized user. On average, in America, 70% of accidental firearm injuries involve children between the ages of 10 and 14. And of the over 500,000 teen suicide attempts per year, over 300,000 involve a firearm.
Isn't it also true that approximately 500,000 firearms are stolen each year? The only safe way to store a firearm is unloaded, with a trigger, blocking, and locking device attached, preferably in a locked case or safe with the ammunition stored in a different location.
People may not know that some states hold the firearm owner responsible for the consequences of any unauthorized use. Even if you have no idea the firearm has been taken, it is your responsibility to prevent children, teens, and unauthorized persons from gaining access to your firearms and ammunition. Use approved locks on all firearms when transporting or storing, and consider storing your firearm in a safe or lockbox. You should also separately lock your ammunition.
Take the time to discuss firearm safety with your children on a regular basis. Teach them not to handle firearms without adult supervision. And never assume that other adults, even family members who own firearms, store them safely in their homes. What should you tell your children to do if they or their friends find a firearm? Leave it alone and tell an adult right away. Remember, your commitment to firearm safety protects not only you, but your entire family. From the ultimate security of a fireproof safe to new mechanisms that provide portability and quick access, there's no reason today for unauthorized use. Any other tips, Officer Douglas?
Here are two more important tips. First, never use drugs or alcohol when handling a firearm. Second, it is always a good idea to complete an approved safety course before handling firearms. Some activities even require passing a safety firearms course.
You're absolutely right. While this video offers the basics of safe handling, take advantage of certified safety trainers in your area. Pass an approved firearm safety program before using a firearm. Contact the International Hunter Education Association, 4-H Shooting Sports, or the National Shooting Sports Foundation for more information. Links to all these organizations and more are available at usashooting.org. High-quality firearms and supplies that you can count on while shooting are important. So, please support the product sponsors of this video who are supporting USA Shooting, the national governing body for Olympic shooting sports. Their links are also available at usashooting.org. And while you're at the USA Shooting website, please join our team and support our top American shooting athletes. Be safe and have fun!